Hey guys, so you may recognize this fiddly fig. You may recognize this shirt, as a matter of fact. And welcome to my home. This is my brand new redone living space behind me, and I'm really excited to share what I've been working on with you guys. It's not 100% done yet, but it's getting really close to getting there. So feels great to be shooting in this new angle with all of this great stuff behind me, all of my house plants. And yeah, I'm just super pumped to be talking about this guy, this fiddly fig, which was my first plant video I ever filmed about a year ago. And he's still here, he's still kicking around, and not only that, this plant is thriving and flourishing, and that's what I want to talk to you guys about in this video. So basically, in this video, I'm going to be sharing with you guys an update on my fiddle leaf fig, along with everything you need to know on how to get your fiddle leaf fig tree to thrive and flourish. Are you with me? All right, so you have to check out all the new growth that I have on my fiddle leaf fig. I have about 3 new leaves coming in here and about 3 or 4 new leaves at the top. It's absolutely insane. This plant is very happy, and I'm just so happy myself that I've been able to really care for and get this plant to the place that it's in. And there are definitely some things that you can do as well to ensure that your fiddly fig is living its healthiest life. Although I need to take a second to address a couple of things. Thanks for checking out this video. I'm Tyler, and if you like what you're seeing or you find this video to be useful, don't forget to give it a thumbs up, or better yet, you can subscribe to my channel. So first off, there were some people who thought that I had killed my fiddle leaf fig from pruning some of the lower leaves. Yes, you made yourselves very clear. You shared a lot of opinions and thoughts in the comments of the older fiddle leaf fig video, so thank you. This plant is still alive. It's doing very well, as you can see. Others of you thought that this plant looked far better before I had pruned it, and there's absolutely nothing wrong with that. Ultimately, I had a ton of folks reach out to me for pruning advice on their fiddle leaf fig. They wanted to know whether or not they should be pruning it, how much, and basically all of those kinds of details. And I was really happy that some folks reached out via email or left comments in the video down below, and I was really happy to work with those folks and help them as much as I could. So if you are someone who has similar questions, by all means, don't hesitate to reach out, leave a comment down below, sound off in the comments, and I am sure to get back to you and help you as much as I possibly can. Now, when it comes to pruning your fiddle leaf fig, here are a couple of things to keep in mind. Now, if you have a smaller or medium-sized fiddle leaf fig, it's probably too soon to even prune it at all. Now, for example, this is one of my smaller fiddle leaf figs, and this guy is far too small for me to even prune it. So if you have a plant this size, you're not gonna wanna prune this. It's really, if you have a tree that's anywhere from 4, 5, 6 feet tall, that's when you can start to think about pruning. So you should really only be considering pruning your fiddle leaf fig if you do have a healthy, larger plant. And if that is the case, then there is a better time to do it. And I'm gonna get into those details right now. For example, it's best to prune your fiddle leaf fig during the growing season when it's getting plenty of really good light. Now, I also had quite a few questions from folks who had browning on their leaves, or they had some brown or sort of purplish spots on their leaves, ask tons of questions. They didn't really like the way those leaves looked and they wanted to know if they could prune them off. All right, so sound off in the comments down below. Let me know if you would like me to do a fiddly fig troubleshooting video, or give this video a thumbs up if you like and want more content like this. In this video, I really want to cover the crucial care tips for the fiddly fig and give you guys some sort of tips and the things that I was able to do to really get my fiddly fig to thrive and flourish. So let's first start with the essential care tips. In terms of lighting, you're really gonna want to keep your fiddly fig in a south-facing window, nice and close. You definitely want to give this plant a lot of bright indirect light, as well as a couple, if not several hours of dapple direct sunlight. What that means is, you know, it's getting little spots and hits of direct sunlight. Now, I can't overemphasize enough that these plants really do need quite a bit of bright indirect light. So if you've placed your fiddly fig in a darker corner, these aren't low light plants. So you're gonna need to grab that. You're gonna need to move your fiddly fig into a nice bright spot. The next most important thing you're gonna want to consider when it comes to your fiddle leaf fig is watering. Let the plant's soil dry out. So now I watered this plant about once a week at most, and this plant was receiving a ton of light. This means that the soil and the roots really had a chance to dry out before the next watering. Now, I think it's really important to emphasize this point and basically encourage you to verge on the side of underwatering your fiddly fig, because if you are overwatering this plant, it's probably the cause and the source of any sort of issues that you may be having, including root rot and particular issues you may be having with your leaves. Now, this is my smaller plant. One of the most common things you'll see are these brown or sort of purplish dots, and this is edema. Now, no one's perfect. This means basically that I've given this plant too much water, and that's why this particular leaf at this stage of the plant, when this was sprouting out, the plant had too much water. Therefore, the leaf looks like this, and these leaves don't grow to full size. They kind of stay this smaller size. It's not, however, the end of the world if you use that as a sign to accept the fact that you are overwatering the plant, then cutting back on watering, and you can get new growth like I have here that is perfectly healthy and fine. So again, just take edema as a sign to cut back on your watering, give your fiddly fig some more sunlight, and just readjust your thinking and your watering schedule, and everything is going to be just fine. Now, if you're interested in pinching or notching techniques for your fiddle leaf fig, check out this video I did a while back. I'm gonna throw up the link here. Okay, so what are the few things you can do to really ensure that your fiddle leaf fig is going to thrive and flourish? All right, so the first thing that I did to get this great looking plant is I ensured this plant got a ton of light. Now, not only did I ensure that it got a lot of light, I made sure that it was getting a lot of light all the way through the growing season and all the way through the winter as well. So this plant got a ton of bright indirect and some direct sunlight consistently throughout the entire year. And I think this is really important. Oftentimes we put plants in a particular spot and it might get great light in the winter, or it might get great light just in the summer. You need to kind of rethink that. If you need to move your plant around, then that's what you need to do in order for it to get consistently great bright light throughout the entire year. The next most important thing you can do is in terms of humidity. These plants love humidity, so grab a humidifier or, you know, purchase one. You're gonna need to bring it right next and place it right beside your fiddle leaf fig. If you are kind of unsure on how much humidity your plant's getting, then that's a great opportunity to pick up a hygrometer. They're very inexpensive. You can grab them on Amazon. And basically, this is a tool that will tell you the percentage of humidity in the air. And you're just gonna wanna make sure that that's at least at 50%. This is particularly important as well in the winter months when the dry, especially where I live, can be very, the air is very dry and there's like, you know, zero humidity. So really, again, that consistency of light and humidity throughout the year is really what I accredit the success to in terms of really allowing this plant to grow, thrive, and flourish. Well, that's it for me. Hope you guys enjoyed this video and found it very helpful. Oh yeah, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up or hit that subscribe button. Miss you guys already. Until the next one.